Wherever you go in the world, this has gone so much into people's mind. If you tell them you meditate, they say, "But Sadhguru, I'm not able to stop my mind." I said, "That will happen only after you stop your kidneys, liver, heart. You stop all these things, then the mind will also stop. Do you want it to stop? No. Then why do you want the mind to stop? Why do you have such a horrible prejudice against the mind? It took millions of years of evolution to get a mind of this kind of capability, isn't it? Millions of years of tremendous amount of nature's work that today you have a mind of this kind of scope. And now you want to stop it.
The term overthinking has been around for so long now. Being in a pseudo sense of self is something we all are stuck in, and the reluctance to let go holds us back from freeing our mind. Many authors over the years have come up with books on the issue, and one such great book, The Power of Now, written by Eckhart Tolle, talks about the same. Tolle says that there is no such place of no thought. But not being actively involved in thoughts while they still happen subconsciously in mind is something that needs to be practiced. The point is not to avoid thoughts but to let them arise without getting drawn towards them, without following them, so as to stay in a state of being. The habit of how not to be driven by mindless wandering is well discussed by Tolle in his book. The book gives three main lessons by which one can practice the art of sensing the presence of the present. Live in now. Life is nothing but a series of present events. A mind is usually preoccupied with either of the two things, the past or the future. However, it's important to understand that the past is nothing more than all the present moments that have gone by. And the future is just a collection of present moments waiting to arrive. To be aware of the present and to accept it is what slows down the overactive mind. Only living in now doesn't help if the thoughts you consume are not positive and rational, which brings in the second point. Feed yourself with good thoughts. Overthinking is one thing and mental diarrhea is another. Consuming the wrong thoughts results in the same. Identifying yourself with someone you are not is a major cause of it. So to think rationally and have good thoughts and to practice the art of not letting negativity seep in helps in freeing one from mind chatters. Even a famous prayer goes by, "Lord, grant me the strength to change the things that I can, courage to accept the things that I can't, and wisdom to know the difference." Now that you understand how important positive thoughts are for the mind, it becomes important to treat them with rationality and logic, which brings in the third point here. Observe but don't judge. You can free yourself from overthinking by constantly observing your mind and not judging your thoughts. Treating yourself and your thoughts with kindness and awareness is the key to not trigger them. The harder you try to push them away, they will come back with more force. And for this, Tolle recommends two things. One, constantly ask yourself, "What will my next thought be?" Two, stop judging your thoughts and urges. To acknowledge their existence and let them rise and pass can help in controlling the overactivity of the mind. Dalai Lama once said, "There are only 2 days in the year when nothing can be done, yesterday and tomorrow. So today is the right day to love, believe, and mostly live." So to conclude, now holds a great power in itself that we can't even think of. accepting your thoughts, respecting them, and peacefully coexisting with them is the righteous way of living life. To stop the mind from mindless chattering, Sandeep Maheshwari once recommended to ask yourself this question: let me observe what my mind is telling me right now. To manage your thoughts, it's important to understand their origin. Remember, the start point of all thoughts is a word, just a word that we feed to our brain. And remember, when you don't give your thoughts a word, they won't speak. And that's why it gives us immense pride in sharing this idea with you, because this could be the habit that changes your life.